迎你来教会，
欢迎来教会，
欢迎你来教会，
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 欢迎你来教会。
Welcome to church.
欢迎你来教会，
欢迎你来教会，
欢迎你来教会。
Many years had passed since Joshua and the Israelites had defeated Jericho, Ai, and the kings of the land. God had allowed the Israelites to rest from battles against their enemies. Now Joshua was getting old. He gathered all the people of Israel because he had some important things to say to them.
Joshua said, "You have seen everything the Lord your God has done. He has fought your battles for you. The rest of the land will be yours too, just as the Lord your God promised. Therefore," Joshua continued, "be careful to obey everything that is in the book of the law of Moses. Do not turn aside from it. Do not mix with the nations in this land or worship their gods. Keep clinging to God. He fights for you. So love the Lord your God. And if you disobey God, he will no longer help you win these battles. In fact, you will die here if you disobey him."
Joshua reminded the people about the things God had done in the past. God had called Abraham and had given him a son, Isaac. He had given Isaac two sons, Jacob and Esau. Jacob's children had become slaves in Egypt, where God had sent Moses and Aaron.
God had rescued the Israelites from the Egyptians, bringing them safely across the Red Sea. They had fought and won many battles because God was fighting for them. God had done so many great things for his people. So Joshua commanded the people, "Fear the Lord and worship him, or will you worship false gods? As for me and my family, we will worship the Lord." The people replied, "We will not abandon the Lord. We know how much God has done for us, and we love him." Joshua warned the people, "If you do abandon God to worship other gods, God will turn against you. He will destroy you." "No," the people replied, "we will worship the Lord."
On that day, Joshua made a covenant with the people. He wrote it down and also set up a large stone under an oak tree. Joshua said, "This stone will be a reminder of your duty to serve the Lord, who kept every promise in bringing you into this land." Then Joshua sent the people back to their homes. After that, Joshua died. He was 110 years old.
As Joshua prepared for his own death, he left behind a legacy of obedience to God. And after Jesus' death and resurrection, he appeared to the disciples and left them with a legacy too, to obey him by making disciples of all nations.
Hi, 小朋友们，你们好，过去的一周过得怎么样呢？你们刚才的故事有听懂吗？今天的故事里面，约书亚在他年纪老迈的时候，把以色列人叫到他的面前，他有一些话要对他们说。第一点，约书亚说到的就是，上帝的话，赐给你们的话，应许给你们的话，没有一句是落空的。也就是说，上帝所有的应许都已经实现了，都已经，成就了。我们每个人不是，说到的每件事情都会做得到，有些时候我们会忘记我们说过的话，但是上帝永远不会忘记他说过的话，上帝的每一句话呢都是带着应许的，也就是说上帝说到的事情他肯定会做到，这一点是约书亚让以色列人记得的。第二点呢，约书亚给以色列人了一个命令，一个诫命。约书亚说，你们要世世代代诚心诚意的，一心一意的侍奉你们的主耶和华，因为他是唯一的真神。因为你们要记得他带领你们出埃及，过红海，战胜了路上的一切的困难， 在沙漠和旷野的里面给你们食物、啊、给你们水喝、啊、他是你们的上帝，是唯一的真神，带你们走到了这里，这个应许之地，这个美丽的地方，所以你们世世代代一定要侍奉他。正如约书亚、在他、完成他的使命之后给我们这样子的一个诫命，耶稣在他完成他地上的使命回到天父上帝身边的之前呢，也把他的门徒叫了过来。耶稣跟他的门徒说什么呢？耶稣跟他的门徒说，我有一条新的诫命要给你们，那就是你们要彼此相爱，因为当你们彼此相爱的时候，众人就认出你是我们的，是我的门徒了。所以小朋友们，今天请记得这句话，我们要彼此相爱。哎，今天跳跳兔怎么没有来呢？我没有看到跳跳兔，他是不是迟到了？大家有谁看到他吗？哎，这里有个小朋友、哦、你好小朋友。
小朋友们，
你叫什么名字啊？
我叫小花。
哦，小花，欢迎你来到主日学。
嗯，谢谢。你是史蒂夫叔叔吗？
是的，你可以叫我 Uncle Steve。
你好 Uncle Steve。跳跳兔说我可以来这边找你，
对，
然后再看故事。
是啊，你来对地方了、刚才的故事你有听到吗？
有哎、就是一个叫约书亚的爷爷给以色列人讲了很多很多的话。
是啊，是啊。
那可是他讲了那么多的话，就是有让我想到一个动画片呢。
想到动画片、哪个动画片呢？
一个叫 Lion King，狮子王的动画片。
哦，我想起来了，我知道你说的是哪一个动画片了，我也知道你说的是哪一段了、
是吗？
那我们要不要快快的看一下？
哇
Father
Remember who you are 小朋友们，你们有看到吗？有看过吗？对啊，就是那一段，就是姆法萨跟辛巴说，记得你是谁 ，Remember who you are。好难哦，难道我们都要像以色列人那样记得那么多？怎么做得到呢？
摩西呢和约书亚是给了以色列人很多的诫命，很多的律法。看似很多的条条框框，但是呢、耶稣来了之后呢，耶稣来到这个世上之后呢，他告诉我们这所有的律法里面、最重要的一条，最重要的两条是什么？
两条。
第一条你要记住，就是要尽心尽性尽意爱主你的上帝。第二条耶稣说也相反，就是要爱人如己。耶稣说这两条就是一切律法的道理和总纲，也就是说这两条呢就是所有律法的概括，所以你要记得这两条并且去遵守这两条，好吗？小花。
原来那就是我们要爱上帝并且爱人如己，彼此相爱，是这样子吗？
是的，小花，你概括的非常的好，非常的棒。
好，
那我们结束之前，小花，你要不要帮我们做一个祷告呢？
我有点害怕哎。
害怕？为什么？
我不知道如何祷告啊。
小花不用害怕，也没有什么好担心的。那么祷告呢，就是跟天父爸爸说话，我们什么都可以跟天父爸爸来说，把你心里想到的说出来就好了。
我想到。那我试一下吧。
好的，那我们一起来祷告吧。
我说，亲爱的天父，谢谢你爱我们，也请你让我们可以彼此相爱。阿门，
阿门。
好了，小朋友，那我们下周见咯。
好，
拜拜，
拜拜。
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Ella from Westland, Michigan asks,
how do I do the right thing when no one else is?
That is a fabulous question. And it's a question many people have to deal with and have to answer. Remember, the Lord is always watching. The Bible tells us His eyes are roaming over the entire earth, and He watches and He sees everything. Also, remember, the Lord will judge. So the Lord will judge you, the Lord will judge the people around you, and the Lord will repay all that we have done, either good or bad. We will receive, the Bible tells us, our just due, our payment for the things that we have done on earth. I would also encourage you to pray for the Lord to give you strength. Oftentimes, we find ourselves in tough situations and in positions where we really, really, really need to call out to the Lord and say, Lord, just give me strength. In addition to praying for the Lord to give you strength, I would also pray that the Lord would change the hearts and the minds of the people around you. We can pray for them. And the Lord loves to answer and to respond to our prayers. Now, if the Lord doesn't respond to your prayer immediately, it's not that He hasn't heard you, but the Lord answers and responds to prayers in His own time. Remember also that the Lord always offers us a way out. So there's a way out for you to not be around, or at least not to take part in the bad things that your friends are doing around you. So think and ask the Lord, Lord, what is the way out of this situation? What is the way out of this position? He has also showed us in the scripture how to act in all cases. Jesus Christ gives us a great example and is a great model for us to act around people who are not doing the right thing. As a word of encouragement to you, I want you to know it's okay to be the only one doing the right thing. And it's okay to be the only one doing the right thing for a really long time. Many Christians before you have found themselves in a position where they are the only person doing the right thing. I would also encourage you to tell a trusted adult of the things that people are doing around you, because maybe a trusted adult can step in and help deal with some of the things that you may just be too small or too young to deal with by yourself. And finally, I think most importantly, is to share the gospel with them if the Lord gives you an opportunity to tell them why you act the way you act and why you don't do the bad things that they do. Share the gospel with them and hope that they would come to know Jesus Christ, because if they come to know Jesus and He breaks open their heart and they want to love Him and be more like Him, then that will change their behavior. What will you say or do the next time you're in a situation where others are doing the wrong thing?